consider this reinforcement, you realize that this is designated B2, while this is designated B1, and they are both on the same slab. Now, what this means is that you have this B1 as the main reinforcement, while this B2 is also equally the main reinforcement. They are both main reinforcements. However, this B1 is the main reinforcement bar on the cross section of this slab across the shorter span, while this is the main bar on the cross section of this slab across the longer span. And you see it's designated 3 L is equal to 3750, Y L of this one is 3450. 3450 is less than 3750. So that's why you have this B1 being the main reinforcement bar, and it's going to be arranged on the bottom layer, while this B2 is going to be arranged right on top of it. Both are main bars.
This 12 means the number of days that we'll be needing to span across this slab, and the Y12 means the diameter of the bar. So in a nutshell, it means that we'll be needing 12 numbers of diameter Y12 of bars to span across this slab. And that also means I will have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of spine across this to this place, this place to this place. So now we go to the next part of the detailing, which is 16. This 16 represents the bar mark, and the bar mark as given can be referenced on the table of quantities and bar bending schedule, which is here. And you see that here you have number, size, quantity, length, total. So now let's go back to the bar mark and try to relate them together. So you have 16 here, so we go to our table and look for 16. So when you get 16, you realize that you have the 16 here, Y12 is the diameter of the bar. So you have 29 quantities that is required. However, we need just 12 of that 29 here, which means there's somewhere else in this slab that requires whatever is left of that.